I would like to read the open letter to Mr. Josep Borrell. Global call for respect for Venezuela by the European Union. The undersigned are writing to you in order to express our concern for the resolution approved on July 9, 2020 by the European Parliament on the humanitarian situation in Venezuela and the migration and refugee crisis, which is in contradiction in the spirit of the joint communique issued on July 1st, 2020 by the Ministry of Popular Power of Foreign Relations of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela and the Foreign Action Service of the European Union, where the parties express, quote, both agree to promote diplomatic contacts between the parties at the highest level within the framework of sincere cooperation and respect for international law, quote end. Unfortunately, there's a majority of members of the European Parliament who insist on a confrontational policy and a policy that identifies with the objectives of the State Department of the US government for the promotion of the regime change policy in Venezuela. These parliamentarians insist on promoting the application of sanctions and stripping the Venezuelan government of its financial resources and blocking its possibilities of accessing the international market for the purchase of food and medicine so necessary in the context of the current COVID-19 pandemic. In this process, they promote the violation of the norms that govern relations between states at the international level. What this is about is the case of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela to seek cooperation mechanisms and constructive dialogue such as those that allowed the recent appointment of the members of the Supreme Electoral Council thanks to an agreement between a sector of the Venezuelan opposition and representatives of the government of President Maduro. This circumstantial majority of the European Parliament fails to recognize that Venezuela has the problems it has due to the terrible consequences of the sanction policy promoted by the United Nations, by the United States, that seek to suffocate the economy in order to produce a collapse punishing 30 million Venezuelans who are denied access to food, medicine, and essential resources to combat the current pandemic. This resolution pays little attention to the real migration problems experienced by the countless Venezuelans who return to the country fleeing from hunger, xenophobia, and coronavirus in neighboring countries of Venezuela. This revolution is in fact opposed to calls made by the UN Secretary General, Pope Francis, and yourself as a high representative of the European Union, among others, to suspend sanctions against Venezuela. One of the worst aspects of the resolution is that it supports the theft by the British government of the gold deposited in the Bank of England by ignoring the right of the Venezuelan government to these resources. The resolution ignores the fact that in January, Mr. Juan Guaido, as a result of his innumerable errors, acts of corruption, links with drug trafficking and Colombian paramilitarism, lost the support of an important sector of the Venezuelan opposition and consequently was not re-elected as president of the National Assembly, even refusing to attend the session where his possible re-election had to be voted on. We highlight that this resolution insists on the regime change policy promoted by the government of Donald Trump in opposition to the joint declaration signed by you and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Venezuela, and seems to promote the repetition of experiences of intervention and interference by the European Union that have ended in terrible bloodbaths and irreparable damage in the intervened countries. For all these reasons, we urge you to maintain and defend your willingness to open dialogue with the government of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela, reinforcing friendly relations and cooperation in full respect for the institutional decisions of the Venezuelan state in the framework of the laws and the Venezuelan democratic process before the legislative elections that will take place on December 6, 2020.